Mashiach and the Book of Samuel and the Origins of the House of David. And in this series of lectures, we are going to investigate the origins of 1 Samuel as it relates to the AM-TUAT, the Egyptian underworld. And this is graphically revealed in pictorials and showing Aph's journey in his Sekhet boat through the hours of the night. This work covers the Book of Samuel, also known as the First Book of Kings. But for those seeking the origins of the Book of Numbers, the Book of Joshua, Book of Judges, and the Book of Ruth, see the 12 Hours of the Egyptian Tuat, the series of lectures that I did on that. These pictorials also found within the tomb of Seti I, and they reveal that the biblical writers have used the pictorials, the various gods, to create a scripture. Though the Bible states that 1 Samuel was composed from the chronicles of Samuel, Gad and Nathan, which you find in Chronicles 1, chapter 29, verses 29 to 30, even so, I shall demonstrate that its main source derives from the Egyptian religion. We are dealing with the Egyptian underworld, which is divided up into 12 hours, and the whole book of Samuel covers those hours. And I shall give a short biblical synopsis of each hour to assist the reader. So we will begin. And first of all, we see the boat of the dead sun god Aph here. And here's Aph, and spelt A-F, who is in the form of a ram-headed man. He wears a disc upon his head and stands within a shrine in the Sekhet boat, i.e. the boat in which the god travels. So we begin with where the boat appears in the register. In this middle register is where the scripture begins, and we follow the scripture as the boat travels. So that is exactly what the biblical writers have done to create the book. So verse 1 of the book of Samuel. Now there was a certain man of Ramathaim Sophim of Mount Ephraim, and his name was Elkanah, the son of Jeroham, the son of Elu, the son of Tuhu, the son of Zuth, an Ephraimite. And here we find the god Nekent F, and he has become Elkanah. Here Nekent F holds a sword in his left hand, and here we see behind him two goddesses, and they are referred to in the next verse. And he had two wives. The name of one was Anna, and the name of the other was Pinah. And Pinah had two children, but Hannah had no children. And here we find the goddess of the south and the goddess of the north have become the wives of Elkanah or Nekent F. Verse 3. And this man went up out of his city yearly to worship and to sacrifice unto the Lord of hosts in Shiloh. And Shiloh here is represented by Kenti Amentet. And it goes on, and the two sons of Eli, Hophni and Phinehas, the priests of the Lord, were there. So here we have the two sons of Elkanah, and this is Hophni and Phinehas here, situated here. But indeed these are the gods of Sekhet and Sechech Ur. Verse 4. And when the time was that Elkanah offered, now we have moved up this register to here. Here once again, Neket F appears, and he has a sword in his left hand, which is means sacrifice. And when the time was that Elkanah offered, he gave to Pinah his wife and to all her sons and her daughters portions. These portions are related to here. These are four portions. These are known as four portions with heads on plinths. And these in the Egyptian text are referred to the four terms. So we go on. Now we go to verse 8 of Samuel. Then said Elkanah, her husband, to her, Anna, why weepest thou, and why eatest thou not, and why is thy heart grieved? Am I not I better than 10 sons? And here we have the sons here, and these figures are seated and worshipping Ra. Verse 9. So Anna rose up after they had eaten in Shiloh, and after they had drunk. Now Eli the priest sat upon a seat by a post of the temple. So Eli sits by a seat, and which means we need to go to the next register, which is below here. And here we see baboons seated. So, and they are by the post. So we go to this register, the lower register here. Verse 9. So Anna rose up after they had eaten Shiloh, and after they had drunk. Now Eli the priest sat upon a seat by the post of the temple. Verse 12. Now the sons of Eli were sons of Belial. They knew not the Lord. So here we have the sons of Belial here, and they are worshipping a beetle. On one side of the beetle is a god with his knees in the direction of the prow of the boat, but having his head turned towards him and his hands raised in adoration of the beetle. And on the other side is a god who also has his hands raised in adoration of the same object. And in the Egyptian text states this as the coming into being of Osiris, the beetle here. Verse 13 of the book of Samuel. And the priest's custom with the people was that when any man offered sacrifice, the priest's servants came. And here's the priest's servants here. While the flesh was in seething, with a flesh hook of three teeth. And here these serpents have become the three teeth in scripture. Verse 19 of the book of Samuel. Moreover, his mother. Now we move up the register to this point here. And this is the goddess Lebeti. Artet, sorry. Made him a little coat. And this is in reference to this god here. And that's Nebati. And this is in reference to Samuel, who ministered before the Lord, being a child, girded with a linen ephod. And this god has a linen ephod, and is carrying scepters relating to kingship. Verse 9:20, and Eli blessed Elkanah and his wife, and said, the Lord give thee seed of this woman for the loan which is lent to the Lord. And they went unto their own home, and the Lord visited Anna, so that she conceived and bare three sons and two daughters. Here are the three sons, 1, 2, 3. And the two daughters are here. 1, 2.